It's a 2.7. They've added 0.6 of a second. But really, this faceoff is ceremonial at best. LaPointe will take it against Andre Nikolishin. The Islanders know that the party is about to begin here at the Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum. John Moran, the linesman, drops the puck. And at long, long last, the New York Islanders will join the chase for the Stanley Cup. The Islanders have made the playoffs. Any champagne celebration after all. It's the regular season and there are still four games to be played. But for players like Claude LaPointe, Kenny Johnson, Steve Webb, guys who have been here the longest, this definitely is something to celebrate.
And you know what, Howie? I mean, maybe this game was emblematic of the struggle because it hasn't been easy to get back to this point. And this game was not easy. Was not an easy way to clinch it.
You know what's going on here? Steve Webb is the third star.
Number 13, Claude LaPointe.
Claude LaPointe's the second. You think Kenny Johnson will be the first? Michael Pekka was their best player tonight, if you ask me. But you know what? Kenny Johnson, yeah. The third. That's great.
Absolutely.
Good for them.
They've been here a long time. They put up with an awful lot. More lows than highs. And three players with an awful lot of heart have hung in there, and this is a special moment.
If you think you saw tears down the face of Claude LaPointe or in his eyes, you weren't seeing things.
And congratulations to the Islanders' first-year head coach, Peter Laviolette, who led this team to the playoffs. First year, it's tough to coach in this league, no matter how much experience you've had in the minor leagues or as an assistant coach. When you become the head coach, things change in a hurry. And Peter Laviolette led this team. They went through that training camp, got off to the marvelous start in October, Howie, and they were flying. And you talk about a young guy that came in, and this team dearly needed some leadership from the coaching position, and they got it. And that man, Greg Cronin, has been here now for 4 years and saw his role change this year from someone that was on the bench to being up there as the eye in the sky and doing an awful lot of work behind the scenes with the penalty killing and coaching all the forwards. So this was a group of coaches that got together, got it together in a hurry, led this team to a wonderful start, and congratulations to them.
And Mike Milbury, wherever you are right now, take a bow, because Mike has put up with so much, and by his own decree, he will not be available tonight. He's going to grab his family, go home, and let the players enjoy the limelight.